President Aquino pronounced his trip to the U.S. and Canada a success. Before leaving, the president met with a Vancouver-based Aquilini Investment Group, one of Canada's most diversified companies. The group committed to increase its investments in businesses in the Philippines. The group has invested over 1.3 billion pesos in a waste-to-energy conversion facility in Cebu. The president made the announcement upon his return home.
Ayon sa kanilang pinunot mga opisyal, interesado silang pumasok sa mga sektor ng enerhiya, turismo at agrikultura. Miski nga po ako, nagulat. Hindi lang kasi mais, kundi pati pagtatanim ng blueberries at cranberries pinag-iisipan na nilang pasukin sa bansa.
Canada is the 10th top destination for Filipinos seeking jobs. The dream of becoming a Canadian citizen has been achieved by over 500,000 Filipinos. But President Aquino says, with the gains under his administration, Filipinos no longer have to leave the Philippines to achieve their aims. Some Filipinos were moved by the president's words.
I've never been homesick yet. Pero nung narinig ko siya, parang ba't ako nandito?
After what he told us about what he did, it's a big invitation for me to go and see if it's really true.
But there were others who felt the president could have done more for Filipino caregivers and domestic workers in Canada. An advocate for the Pinoy caregivers, estimated at about 50,000, says a government-to-government agreement could have protected the rights of the vulnerable sector.
But if you don't give protection to people, how can they contribute productively to the vibrant economy?
Not all Filipino workers here are successful and need the protection of their government back home. Cesar Oreña Drilon, ABS-CBN News.